skating to Claire de Lune for her short program, and this was choreographed by Lori Nickel. Opening with her triple lutz, triple loop combination. You can see she has wonderful lyrical qualities to her skating. Nice, soft, bouncy knees that allows her to float across the ice. She left her coach of nearly 3 years, Rafael Artunian, and joined forces with legendary coach Tatiana Tarasova. Now she splits her time between Moscow and Tokyo. Final jump out of a spread eagle, double axel, looking very composed and relaxed. You know, it's so interesting with the new style of training that she undertook in Russia. She didn't want to hurt her new coach's feelings by telling her that she didn't agree with her, but when she realized, obviously, it was not going to work after France, she's gone back and more ice time, more repetition, and every skater's different. Every skater knows what brings them confidence. Some just need repetition, 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 and obviously, that works for Mawasawa. And Tracy, that would leave her in first place after the short program with a score of 64 points. And like you said, what a difference a couple of weeks does make.
Asada Mao-san no engi deshita.
So American Ashley Wagner was second after the short. Finland's Laura Lepisto was third. Two Japanese skaters sat fourth and fifth. When we turn to Yoyogi Stadium in Tokyo, Canadian
knows what the problem is. She's got a few weeks going into nationals to solve it.
Our next skater, Yukari Nakano, who finished second at Skate America earlier this season.
Well, she's in fifth place after the short program. Very disappointing for her, trying to climb onto the podium and get a chance at the Grand Prix final. Skating to Giselle. Solid double axel to open this program that's choreographed by Marina Zueva. I think this program is delightful. If she can skate it well and land the jumps, just watch her face light up. First triple, triple flip.
Tracy, she needs a top two finish today, and that would guarantee her a spot in that Grand Prix final.
Well, I would say she's off to a flying start here. Very determined opening.
She's been referred to as the Rodney Dangerfield of Japanese skating. Really gets no respect. The 23-year-old has often been overshadowed by some of the country's younger skaters in the past.
Thank you.
delightful performer. Her weakness is her air position and her triple jumps. Watch here how her free leg in the air wraps high and around her skating leg. And that is technically not strong, and really her only weakness, in my opinion, is a skater.
She was on the wrong end of the selection process for that 2006 Japanese Olympic team. Despite winning bronze at the Grand Prix final and silver at the Four Continents, she was not given a spot. A lot of people were surprised by that.
Combination triple toe, double loop. Again, fifth after the short program, knowing she needed to deliver here to have any chance at the Grand Prix final, taking advantage of skating at home, the warmth of the audience. What a charming performance for Yukari Nakano.
Certainly a huge improvement over her short program, that's for sure. And like you said, Tracy, may well have been enough to earn her third career trip to a Grand Prix final.
So hard in competition to be able to just get in that zone where you're performing and skating and sure on your blade. She came out looking very, very determined, knowing she had a job to do. Nailed all of her opening jumps. Here's a look at her triple salchow, but what I loved was once she got through the early moments of her performance, she was able to relax into the music. As the music changed and softened, so did she. And I think this was such a great choice of music. Again, her choreographer, Marina Zueva. Nobusatu there is her coach, and he's also the father of Yuka Sato, world champion.
Well, you think you'd need a score of over 100 to get onto the podium in Tokyo today, and she has that and more. That is the best free skate so far of the afternoon and moves her into first place. Well, Japan, as you know, Tracy, has loads of talent in women's figure skating. And wouldn't the Japanese fans love to see a sweep of the podium by their hometown skaters today? And it could happen. Akiko Suzuki was fourth after the short program. And Tracy, this is her first senior Grand Prix appearance at 23 years of age.
Skating here to Dark Eyes, and as you mentioned, she was a very strong junior skater. In 2001, she finished seventh at Junior Worlds, competed a little bit nationally as a senior, but she has had a number of health issues. She was out of competition for a couple of years, reportedly an eating disorder. Seems to have that behind her now. Nice start there, opening with her triple lutz, double loop. Thank you. axel triple toe for her second jump. So here we have a skater. You talk about the depth in Japanese skating. In her first international, just off the podium after the short program, with the real possibility of getting a medal in her first senior international. Triple loop. Boy, does she look composed.
Wouldn't every other country in the world die for what Japan has in the women's competition?
Triple flip into a triple lutz. Step out of the landing there, but she has an easy height, good spring in her jumps. Triple loop up into a double axel.
Performance by the 23-year-old skater. Certainly she should challenge her teammate Yukari Nakano for the lead.
Imagine your first senior international and you go and you skate like that. Such sureness. A double axel into a triple toe. It looked like she didn't quite complete the rotation on the second jump. The judges and the technical specialists, in fact, will analyze that jump. But I just loved her confidence in the in her performance. And you look at the Japanese women, and as you said, Brenda, just how any country would love to have their depth. But what that affords them is endless opportunities for exhibitions and shows. The skating's so popular. You can see the number of people in the audience. So every time you go out and you perform, it's practicing with that extra adrenaline and energy and helps them to manage it in competitions. And look at the score there.
Wow, so that is 0.03 of a point higher than Yukari Nakano's free program score. Our new leader is this woman. So right now, the Japanese skaters are sitting 1-2.
And when you think Yukari was fourth in the world, what an accomplishment.
Well, for a few years now, Brian Joubert has been considered the number one skater in France. Alban Préaubert considered number two, but a lot of people think our next skater could give Alban a run for his money. This is Yannick Pancero.
He has a new team. He's working off the ice with specialists and also has a sports psychologist, which he says has really helped him this year. He's had good success in competition. Here's a look at his quad. Quad toe to open, and that was a gorgeous jump. Wonderful height and flow on the landing. Triple axle, good speed, and again, superior jump. A little back on the landing of that one. Big sports.
At Skate Canada, he was first after the short program, but fell to fourth overall and missed his chance to contend for a spot in the Grand Prix final.
Oh, beautiful jumps. I love the height. Controlled explosion. You remember back at Skate Canada, he started off well in the free skate. It was almost like halfway through the program, he thought, I can win this. He switched from offense to defense. He gave away too many points at the end of his program and finished right off the podium.
He has a problem that many skaters have, and that is that he's great in practice, but when it comes to competition, just cannot translate that performance that we see in practice over to the competition.
Well, sometimes you just want it too much. It's a fine, fine line. I think one of the things that's helping him as well this year is the character he's brought to his performances. And when you really get into the music and you get into the program, it totally relaxes you, gets you into your legs, and that helps with the jumping. Could have been a second triple axel. He chose to do a double. Should remind you, jumps after the halfway mark earn an extra 10% bonus. Triple salchow into two double toes there. Looking a little tired, turned a triple loop to a double. You notice at the beginning of the program, he took all this speed into his jumps, and now he appears to be pulling back a little bit. And there's a triple toe at the end. Oh, just leaning out of the landing on his triple salchow. Syncopation in this footwork sequence gets you tapping your toes right along with them. Come on, one more. Double axel at the end of his program.
Yannick Pancero. Well, that performance may have earned him the first Grand Prix medal of his career.
Well, once again, like we saw at Skate Canada, he started out like gangbusters. He backed off a little bit in the second half. Let's take a look at this axel. Nice air position, good height, and you can see he carries out the flow in the landing, but gets a little bit back on the blade, so has to touch his second foot down. Picks up the bulk of the marks, not the extra there in the quality of the jump. He gets big points for his quad at the beginning of the program. Almost 10 points for the jump, and then definitely extra marks for the quality of the quad. Part of it is when you get out in competition, we talk about the difference from practice to competition. You waste energy at the beginning of the program. You have all this adrenaline and it kind of gets trapped and blocked and creates a bit of a struggle, which fatigues you through the performance. He's very happy with his scores. He's still got a lot of time left in the season to get that second half delivered the same as the first.
Well, there is just one of two men left to skate now, the 2008 World Bronze. Tracy, here is our final skater of the afternoon, 21-year-old Nobunari Oda. This is his only Grand Prix event of the season because he did not compete for the past year and a half. He wasn't eligible to enter two Grand Prix events, and you need those two competitions to have any chance of qualifying for the final.
He was out of competition because he was charged with drinking and driving, and so his federation suspended him for a year, and then he took some extra time off for good measure. Now, back and opening with his quad. A little tentative on the landing of his quad. Here comes his triple axel. Again, back on the blade. Triple salchow, triple toe. You can see his trademark deep knee bend on the landing of both of those jumps.
Competed in the Japanese Nationals in 2008, but he declined, saying he was under too much mental stress. If he would have competed there, he probably would have got the two Grand Prix spots this season.
Not only is he a skating star, and so there was much attention with his drunken driving charge, but he's also a 17th descendant of the legendary warlord Nobunaga Oda. And so feeling a lot of shame from what happened and rebuilding back now and hoping to rebuild his skating career. Second triple axel planned here, much better than the first one.
For a few years, he trained out of Barrie, Ontario with Coach Lee Barkel, but in May of 2007, changed coaches, joining Nikolai Morozov, the coach of Oda's main rival, which was interesting, a 2007 World Silver medalist, Daisuke Takahashi. That didn't go over too well. Daisuke ended up leaving shortly after.
Unlike The rest of his competitors, who got off to good starts and struggled at the end of the program, he's getting stronger and stronger throughout this performance.
Nobunari Oda makes an impressive return to the Grand Prix stage here at home in Japan.
Oda Nobunari-san's演技でした.
Well, you could see him kind of going in and out of his comfort zone throughout the program. Let's see how he opened here with his quad. He gets fully around on the landing, actually over-rotates the landing, so he will get some marks for that, not full marks because of the step out. Here's his triple axel. You can see he's leaning in the air. And again, I think his shoulders and his body was ready to do an extra revolution on that triple axel. Though as the program went on, he got stronger and stronger. He had some beautiful triple jumps towards the end of the program, including a very strong triple axel.
He's going to need a score of 143 to move ahead of Johnny Weir. And into first place, there is Nikolai Morozov. And his mother beside him, the coach herself, Norika Oda. And that will be 8 points higher than Johnny Weir's free skate score. In fact, those are the third, that's the third highest score in the free skate this season. And combined, that's the second highest score behind Patrick Chan of Canada. Welcome back, Nobunari Oda.
And there's his infectious smile that we have missed for the past couple of years. So Nobunari Oda takes the gold medal here at home. American Johnny Weir finishes with another silver medal. Well, France's Yannick Pansereau is third, and a good showing by Canadian Kevin Reynolds as he finishes fourth. Now let's go down to James Powell.